their tanks and their bombs and their bombs and their guns in your head. In your head, they are crying. Say you have a bunch of classes that all need to have the same thing in them. Like, you have a game with a bunch of inventory items. You could have a single interface for an inventory item, and then all of the classes that inherit from it, like say a weapon or a piece of armor, would inherit from that single class. And then you could deal with all those items together as if they are that base class, that base interface. Because if you treat it like the interface, then you can use those methods that the interface implements. So what is an example of this? An example would be if you had the interface. That's too small.
Hey, Theodore.
So you have an interface for the shape class, or rather, the shape interface. And this would have the method like, say, area. And so if you were to make any class that inherits from shape, it would have to have the method area. And then you can see here that although we have a method here, there's just a semicolon at the end, so it doesn't actually define an implementation. So the shape itself won't do anything, but if you have, like, say, a circle, interfaces are most useful structures. So one of the common uses are if you're making some sort of plugin system, or say if you have a game and you want to have mods, you define some interface for a mod or a plugin, and then every plugin will inherit from that interface. And then the program would be able to load that mod or plugin and then use some generic methods like, say, get name or get version to get information about that mod so that it can run properly. So you can also have fields and interfaces. Like say I wanted a variable to keep track of, so I can store that area. We can have double A, and then if you were to create that shape, A would store the area so that you wouldn't have to run the method and discover the area each time. So, moving on to LINQ or LINQ, it stands for Language Integrated Query, and basically it lets you take a set of data or a set of objects and do a single operation on the entire set, or compare all of them, or get just objects that fit certain criteria. This is more common in what are called functional programming languages, where that's the only kind of operation you can do. Whereas C# is a object-oriented language where you have individual objects that do things, but it still allows you to do this sort of functional programming, because it can be useful for shortening certain writing code is a lot shorter to do the same thing. Two of the data types that we use in LINQ are lists and dictionaries. It's very similar to an array in that it stores a dimensional array of values or objects. The difference being that with a list, with a list you can add or remove objects dynamically. So if you were running your code, you could have a list that has two objects and then add a third object to it. Whereas with an array, that wouldn't be enough. You'd have to create an entire new array of size 3 and then copy objects over. And a dictionary is very similar. The difference difference is that you're allowed to define your own keys. So instead of storing just a single object, it stores pairs of objects. To give some examples, where can you see all of it?
You can see the entire report. As a matter of fact, from a recent treatment in Theodore, goofing off on his phone.
Yeah, here. If you sit down, you won't be able to see. On the chair. Like wherever you were sitting.
Okay, I think I'll take it over here. If you were to create a list. Let's make it a list of integers. So in this case, 0, that's just basically saying, is x even? So is the remainder after x divided by 2 equal to 0? If we were to do this and turn it into a lambda expression, you'd have the arguments. So in our case, it would be x. The lambda symbol, which is the equal sign, and the greater sign, greater than sign. And then after that, you have whatever it returns. So we have x. So this is saying, take the list none and give me all the items where if you take some value x, not what the list, and that value is divisible by 2. This method is a bit weird in that it doesn't return a list. It returns a generic interface that list inherits from. So we have to convert it back into a list. So there's another method that is dot to list. And that is the end of the expression. So if we were to now evaluate these three lines, we see at this point num has 2, 3, 4, and 2 in it. And then once you execute this line, it should give us all the even items. So the list should now have 2, 4, and 2 in. And if you were to run it, you would get that result. And you can apply a similar function to the dictionary. The dictionary is a bit different, not much, in that if you were to create a dictionary, you have to give both the type of values it's storing and the type of keys. So in this case, we're going to use a string. To give integer. Let's say
Wait, why is that a... Oh, it's supposed to be cool. All right, I got you.
Okay, so who's number four?
I have
who's number four?
Theodore.
Oh, cool.
And then you're here to
put... All right, yeah, we get it. We're not important enough to be listed.
So now, in order to get some elements, say, where you put where...
You're literally the loudest person in the room despite the reverb.
You mean feedback? The tech in this room is the fault.
There are also other methods in LINQ that allow you to sort. So you could decide to say sort this dictionary by ranking, the order of ascending, descending.
I have 2 minutes.
I know. And then I can see it. each class grade S and no. Reiteration of the loop, S would represent the next string within the num list. So whereas before you had the index of that object, now you're getting the object itself. One difference between here and with arrays is that you can't modify the original list within this loop. Because modifying the original list will interfere with iterating on them. So if you were to remove an item from the list, that would cause it to skip items and stuff like that, so it's not allowed. You could copy the list.
Films in our new location, an undisclosed location. Yeah, we might be on Mars. We might be launched up with the what's the space of the Starman. Yeah. All right, good show.